As I said, I planned to when I was just starting, but now...
The first 50 seconds are the most important. You have to hook the audience so that they watch till the end.
Hi, my name is Vav and this is my first game in Unity. So for the last couple of years I had a dream of making my own video game. But since I knew I'm gonna suck at programming, I really never tried to make one. But finally, I'm here and I'm ready to dedicate a couple of months from my life to making a game and share the results with you. And let's be clear by what I mean I'm making my first game, because I've seen a lot of people on YouTube claiming to make their first game in a month, in a week, or even in 24 hours, and the game has like 100 levels, multiplayer mode, supports VR headset. But now when I actually tried to make the game myself, I surely know that's a very hard thing to do. So it's either not their first game, or it took much more time than it was claimed in their YouTube titles. Or they are all geniuses and I'm the stupid one, which is probably the case. So yeah, in my case, I have no experience in coding. The only languages I am familiar with are HTML and CSS, which have nothing to do with C#. Unity's interface is also unknown to me, as I never used it before. Alright. As I said, I have no prior knowledge of how to code or use Unity, so the first thing we need to do is to learn some stuff, and I was really scared of that part. What usually happens to most people when they want to learn something is that they spend little time watching some videos, doing the research, then immediately start trying to implement that knowledge, which is obviously not enough. In my case, it is the opposite. I spend a lot of time doing the research, watching the videos, and when it's the time to use that knowledge, I usually just quit and go learn something else. And I was really scared that the same thing is gonna happen now, but fortunately that wasn't the case. So the first week of making the game was dedicated to learning C# basics and Unity's interface. I was watching around 8 hours of videos per day without trying to code anything. And after a week of research, I know about variables, methods, inheritance, Unity-specific methods like start, update, fixed update, rigid bodies, colliders, animations, and lots of other stuff. Now it's time to try to make a game, and when I say make a game, I just mean following 8-hour tutorial trying to do everything it says, otherwise it's gonna return an error I'm never gonna fix. So the first prototype is ready, it's obviously a garbage, but we have a working game and I'm pretty happy at this moment. Alright, now when I feel a little comfortable with using Unity and writing my own scripts, it's time to come up with an idea of what the game is actually gonna look like and start working on it. And as you can guess, that's not that easy. As it was my first project and I didn't know how to make 3D models, I decided to start with a comparably easy project and make my game in 2D. And thinking of 2D games, I remembered a couple of them that I really enjoyed playing or watching. I Wanna Be the Guy and Trap Adventure. So the main concept of both games is that they are super hard to complete, and to pass each level you have to fail many times until you understand how the secret traps work in each level. But if you lose all your lives, you have to start over from the very beginning. So I decided to make the game with the same concept of having tons of traps and being super hard to play, and at the end hopefully release the game on Google Play. I started designing some levels in Photoshop and set myself a goal to make 15 unique levels, and that turned out to be the most difficult part of the whole project. I was really surprised that designing and thinking of new unique traps and levels turned out to be harder than actually making those levels in Unity. And after spending a week on creating the first 5 levels, I got stuck and couldn't come up with new unique ideas. I could easily spend hours just looking at the screen like stupid and still have no clue how to design the new levels and what traps to put there. So I decided to actually make the first levels in Unity and then add the new levels as we complete the previous ones. And in a couple of days the first levels are ready. Then right after that I quickly found a 2D character on Google, wrote a couple lines of code for player movement, and now we are good to go. I said, we are good to go. So the controls of the game have to be good. Yeah. Especially in my game where you have to react fast to the traps and dodge them, the controls have to be super responsive. Setting up the controls usually takes months in big projects, and actually took a lot of time in my project too. Even during the last stages of the development, I was still making changes in the control system. So after a couple of days of coding, now we can move left and right, jump and squat. But for now, even though the code works fine, the movement feels uncomfortable and sometimes gives a feeling of not working properly. What I mean by that is when you hit the jump button right at this point, when very close to the ground but still in the air, the player will not jump and you're gonna think that the code didn't work. So I set up a buffer and coyote time, and now we can jump when we are close to the ground, and we can also jump within a fraction of a second when we step off the platforms. Finally, I added changes in the gravity system when a player is moving downwards after jumping, and now the controls feel really cool. So for the next couple of days, I decided to work on the main menu and game over scenes. I started making a background image for the main menu using one of my previously created levels as a template, edit play and settings buttons on the canvas, then edit a camera shake by following Breaky's tutorial, and finally wrote the script for spawning fireballs from random places. And I haven't decided the name yet, so we're going with Trash Adventure, I guess, for now, cause you know, like, the game is trash and the name. After that, I made a mode selection system where we can decide whether to start a game with 10 lives or with 2 lives, and for now the 10 lives mode is always available, but later you'll have to watch a short advertising video to play one time with 10 lives. The game over scene is also a simple scene where every time you die, the game displays some kind of motivating quote or sometimes a little message from me. So, after a week of torturing myself, now we have a main menu from where we can select the mode and start the game. When we die, we go to the game over scene, and from game over scene, we can go to the main menu and start over. So during the time of making the main menu, I was also trying to design the new levels, and after creating some, I decided to divide the levels by different categories. The first 5 levels are easy to pass, and after dying a couple of times, you learn where the traps are and easily pass them. The next 5 levels also have different traps that you have to explore, but to pass them you have to make a couple of precise jumps and moves. And the final levels are obviously the most difficult ones. So the moment you spawn into the level, you immediately have to move, jump or take some other action so that you don't die. So the next week I was busy creating new levels and trying to make as many unique traps as possible. At this point I'm trying to show as many levels as I can, but at the same time I don't want to spoil the game for you, so it remains interesting when you play it. So I made a level where a red fireball is chasing you and you have to completely turn off your logic to pass the level. Then I added another level with pipes, where you're never gonna guess how to pass it until you die like a million times and try all the possible outcomes, more like down ways to die. A level with a moving ceiling where you have to move your ass pretty fast to manage to hit all the buttons before getting smashed by the ceiling. A couple of dark levels with some moving floors and some scary fast spike walls. And finally, I remember that I'm making a mobile game, not a PC game. And to move in a mobile game, we need some buttons. Yeah. It's kinda important. So I quickly made some buttons in Photoshop, and after a couple of days of sleepless nights, I was finally able to build the game on my phone and play it. Then after being unable to play my own game with this buttons, I understood that the button's working area has to be way larger so that you don't need to precisely click on the button. Now the gameplay is way more comfortable and now you can focus on what's happening on the screen rather than trying to hit the buttons in the right place. At this moment I'm super happy with the results so far, and even though it's been about 2 months of work without day offs, I'm satisfied with what I have. So the next thing we need to do to bring this game to life and make it less boring is to add some sound effects. And after a quick search on Google, I came across a website that randomly generates cool sound effects for games, and now we have sounds for running, jumping and dying. Then I added more sound effects to different objects in the game, like electricity sounds, moving walls, dropping pipes, and it's already pretty good, but something is still missing. The background music. So after a couple of more days of searching the music and setting up Unity, now we have super cool background music that changes the mood of the game as you complete the easy levels and get to the hard ones. At this moment we got about 10 levels, we got our menu setup, super cool sound effects, and we can actually build and play the game on the phone. And before moving to creating some new levels, I decided it's time to integrate some ads to the game. So for the advertising in my game, I chose AdMob ads instead of Unity ads because I don't know why, and after reading some guidelines on how to implement the ads in the game, I quickly set up everything and now it's working pretty good. Ha! That was a joke. Cause you don't know that, but I'm pretty stupid for that stuff right now. So basically we need two types of ads. A rewarded ad that you can watch for about 30 seconds and then you can start the game with 10 lives, and interstitial ad that is about 5 seconds or less that you have to watch every time you lose all your lives and the game is over. So after a day of searching how to easily make this stuff work, I finally found a video on YouTube explaining all that complicated stuff in human language. And now we have our test ads working like a charm. We can play with 2 lives or we can watch a rewarded ad and play with 10 lives. After that I thought it's a good idea to give an option to remove all ads from the game and be able to always play with 10 lives. And with the help of another video from the same channel, I set up in-app purchases and now with 99 cents you can remove all ads from the game and also get 1 additional life at the start of the game per 2000 score that you earn from playing. So if you play for a week and gain 10,000 score, you will start the game with 15 lives instead of 10. As I said, I planned to have 15 levels when I was just starting, but now... but now I'm thinking it's gonna be very easy to complete the game in like a couple of days if you are a true gamer like me. So I decided to add 5 additional levels with a slight change in the gameplay. So I added a couple of new levels with fireballs and as you pass them you unlock a jetpack. Yeah, now we need to make a jetpack. So I found a model of a jetpack, changed it slightly in Photoshop to fit my player, wrote a new movement controlling script, and now we can fly. The next couple of levels we fly with a super cool jet, die a couple of million times until we get to the space-ish level, where presumably there is no oxygen and we die without an astronaut helmet. Finally, I had to solve the problem what to do with the player if someone loses his mind and decides to fly too high and actually leave the level. And I think I know what to do. So before moving to creating the final level, I decided to go back and work on fixing some minor issues in the game. And by minor issues, I mean fixing tons of bugs and low FPS rate. Cause right now on certain levels, the game goes crazy and kills the player with 30 FPS gameplay. Actually, I don't see any difference myself, cause my brain also works at 30 FPS, but you might see the problem when you play it. So I made a quick search on Google on how to fix the FPS issue in the game, and with the help of Unity profiling, I quickly found in what scripts out of dozens I made most stupid stuff, like putting a lot of unnecessary code in updates, or making some simple code too complicated and long. And after some days of rewriting everything, we are still fixing the issue, cause it happened to be that I made a lot of stupid stuff. After a couple of more days, we're done with optimizing scripts, but the main cause of low FPS rate turned out to be the lights. So I found out that Unity uses a lot of resources for rendering lights in real-time mode, and that is killing my FPS. Eventually I fixed the lights issue by removing some of them, and also completely removing lights from the scenes where I don't need them. And finally we can play with a good FPS rate. So after dealing with some boring stuff, we can return to making the final level and the game completion scene. As I said earlier, the final levels have to be the most difficult and intense ones. So that's exactly what we're going to do. I added some super epic background music, a an earthshake, a f***ing lava to limit your time, and of course the final traps until the finish line. And if you're lucky enough to finish the final level, you win the game and get to the game completion scene. Alright, so when making the game complete level, I was thinking about the emotions of the player who has just finished the game, and remembered the moment in my childhood when, after a month of playing Warcraft with my friend, we were thinking we're gonna get some special secret prize for the players who just won the game, like $1 million. And we were like pretty disappointed when just a message came saying like, thank you, and that's all. We were devastated by that ending. So I tried not to make the same mistake and added a secret ending for you, which obviously you can see only after completing all 20 levels. And of course I'm not gonna reveal it now. Wanna know what it is? Go play the game. Eventually, after a couple more days of fixing final bugs, the game was ready to get published on Google Play. So at this stage the game is completely ready for the release, and let's actually... So I quickly hit up my bro to help me with the name of the game. And now we have it. Holy trap. Cause it's a trap. Holy trap. Anyways. I made a short trailer for Google Play in the final cut, then made an icon for the game and couple of screenshots of the gameplay. And let's actually watch the trailer. So right after that, when everything was ready, I tried to release the game, and my worst nightmare came true. If you know me, then you know that my most hated thing in this life is waiting. The moment when you cannot do anything else but to wait until something happens. And in this case, I had to wait for more than 2 days for the game to get published. I was literally dying. I could not eat, could not sleep. I was shaking in convulsions in the bed until that long 2 days passed and the game finally got published. So now that we got published on Google Play, we can add the game into the AdMob account to enable the real ads in the game. And... Finally, after 4 days of endless suffering, the game is released. The ads are working fine and I officially finished the game. Overall, it took me straight 4 months to make a game without any previous knowledge of programming or Unity. These were great 4 months, with a lot of moments when I was completely exhausted, sometimes too tired of working non-stop, but I was enjoying every aspect of developing a game and never thought of quitting. At this moment I want to thank you for watching until this point, and please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel if you like the content. I really put my heart into making this game and I'm curious what you guys think about it. Also, I'm thinking to start making more dumb games like this and post more YouTube videos about the creation of those games. So if you would like to see more of these kind of videos, please let me know in the comments below. That would really help and motivate me to make more fun stuff. Also, join my Reddit by the link in the description, cause that's where I'm gonna post information about the future games and hopefully get useful feedback for you about what to do or not to do in future games. Feel free to suggest any stupid or genius stuff and I'm gonna respond to everyone. So I guess that's all for this video and see you in the next one.